start out with this clip, first of all, because it's really, really funny, and second of all, because the critic actually makes a really good point at the end.
Why the need for so much gruesome, graphic violence? Why not let us imagine?
Because it's so much fun, Jan.
Really? You're doing great. What do you care about me? All right, Quintana, look, it's your genre, you own it. It's your genre and you own it. And that's why he's Quentin Tarantino doing so.
Alright, so I showed that clip because even the critic kind of concedes at the end in that like awkward laugh that she does that it's like it really is his own genre. It's amazing. He's doing well. And so like when I did my paper I wanted to figure out what makes it, like what makes you sit down and when you watch a Tarantino be like, oh yeah, I know that's a Tarantino movie. So there are certain things that in like combined make it a Tarantino. It's the actors he uses, the fact that he ends up in a lot of his own movies, the scenes and camera shots that he does, techniques that he uses, and points of views that he comes from. So a lot of his favorite actors he first used in Pulp Fiction, and he's used them over and over again, like Samuel L. Jackson. And then some of them he waits until he has the perfect role for them, like Uma Thurman, he used her in Pulp Fiction. And then he waited almost 10 years to use her again in Kill Bill as the bride. And he's actually called Uma Thurman his muse, which I think is really cute. As cute as Quentin Tarantino can possibly be. So these are some other actors that he likes to use. Most recently, he used Brad Pitt as the lead in Inglourious Basterds. And he used him back in the day in a movie that he wrote called True Romance. And he likes to work with Rosario Dawson, Christopher Walken, and all the rest. All these that I've listed, he's used at least two. I think that's a testament to Quentin Tarantino, too, to his directing, that they'll work with him over and over. Another actor that he likes to use is himself. He gives himself pretty prominent roles to, like, entire scenes where he has lines and stuff. He's a pretty good actor. He's been in Reservoir Dogs, Death Proof, Pulp Fiction, and the first one that he was in was My Best Friend's Birthday, which isn't available anymore because some of it burnt, but that was the first one that he directed, wrote, and acted in. So... he also likes to do a lot of the same scenes. He likes to do torture scenes, go figure, and violent awakenings. And the funny thing about the violent awakening is that he used it in both Pulp Fiction and then in Kill Bill. And it was very reminiscent of Pulp Fiction and Kill Bill because it was Uma Thurman twice. So both times it was her and you kind of watch it and you're like, well, it's just like Pulp Fiction. He likes to do really important stuff in bathrooms, like Vincent Vega dying in Pulp Fiction. And he likes to do important stuff in cars. So scenes like in Sin City, the only scene that he directed was done in a car. And he also likes to do stuff in bars and restaurants. And the dance scene is kind of like a signature Tarantino thing. And this is the song from Pulp Fiction that he uses for like the classic most famous dance scene that he's done, where Uma Thurman and John Travolta are dancing at the like 50s theme restaurant. And I think he does the dance scene to kind of offset the really violent stuff that's in his movies. Because it was just like a fun, good time. So he's done dance scenes in all of these movies also. He also has his like patented camera shots that he does. He likes to do close-ups, like on record players and women's lips, and especially women's feet. A lot of his main characters have foot fetishes because Tarantino has a foot fetish. Discovered this in my research. So like if you watch his movies, just like women's feet throughout the whole thing, it's great. He likes to work with mirrors and like the main character focusing on them and what's behind them in the mirror. And he likes to do a lot of stuff in black and white. So like Kill Bill and part of Death Proof is in black and white, a scene of that to kind of add to the second rate feel of that movie. And then he does the same points of view over and over again, like the trunk point of view where someone's in the trunk of a car looking up, or the similar one, which is the corpse point of view, which you'll see in the last clip that I show. And then he does the God's Eye point of view, that's just kind of a complete aerial shot. These are things that he's mastered and just uses over and over. And then he has certain techniques, like the definition that he used in Grindhouse, which was the double feature that he did with Rodriguez. And he did the same thing back in the day in Pulp Fiction, just like starting a movie off with a definition. And then he also works with unconventional storytelling a lot, which is impressive and like really brave of him because he's been known to say that he hates getting confused in a movie because he gets so like emotionally enthralled with the movie that check out or leave because he can't deal with it and it just bothers him so much. But he experiments with it a lot, which I think is really brave of him. So he does like non-linear, out-of-sequence stuff, like in Pulp Fiction, and he works with retrospect and stuff like that. And, all right, so what is Quentin's like signature theme in every movie? I should have planned it somewhere, but good. All right, so there's violence in all of his movies. And so I'm going to show this clip to demonstrate that. But if you guys like are prone to bad dreams, you don't want to watch this. I'm going to try to mute it when they cuss. But yeah, on this note, I hope you enjoyed my presentation. Ha ha ha.